everyone. In this video, I'm going to be doing a continuation of my December album prep, mostly using this month's Thompson's craft supplies kit called Frosty Winter. If you didn't see the first video where I actually made the album that you're seeing on screen right now, then I will link that for you if you are interested. But yes, today's video is very much about getting some pages and some pockets and stuff prepped to get like a head start on doing all that documenting in December. So I'm just kind of going through papers at the moment, figuring out what I want to use. I did off screen, you can just see it in the top left there, I made myself a little page marker kind of thing, just getting a strip of paper and then marking, you know, putting a pen through the holes of the album, just so, because they're kind of unusual spaces between the holes, I just thought it would be really handy to have this, and it turned out yes it was. So the first thing I'm going to do is use the cardstock from the kit. I'm not sure, I can't remember if it's A4 or letter size, because I think it was an American brand, which would probably make it letter size, but A4 and letter size are close enough. That's by the by. Anyways, I'm going to use these to make some pockets for the front and back cover. So I'm just kind of matching up the colours that I think will go together the best. And then on the pieces that are going to be at the front of the pocket, just sort of cutting a curved shape in just like that, just totally freehand drew it, and then when I do the second one, I'm just going to use the other one as a template there. So really simple pockets, nothing complicated at all. I just thought they would be really handy for putting stuff in like the album that I don't want to stick down yet. Like at the moment, I'm going to put stuff in the pockets like things I want to use throughout the month, like those little Project Life photo pockets and stuff, and I'll put my marker in there and all that kind of thing. But also throughout the month of December, you know, as I pick up receipts, tickets, maybe print more photos that I might want to use that day, you know, stuff like that. So handy little pockets. Now, as much as I love the colours of this cardstock, just right up my street, I did want to make them a little more interesting for putting in my album. So I'm going over them with some Distress Oxide in Tumbled Glass. I think I used that for all of them, I think, I could be wrong there. And then I'm spraying water all over, and then once that dries, it kind of creates this sort of icy snowy effect. Like you saw when I was putting the oxide on that first blue piece, you couldn't really see it because it's kind of the same color, but once you, you know, spray the water and the ink oxidizes, then you do get this really nice little snowy effect. Unfortunately, it doesn't really show up in the pictures that I'll have at the end for you, but hopefully you can see now that this kind of effect that I'm talking about. So I was quite pleased with that little thing I did there. However, not on this piece, on this turquoisey piece, it wasn't quite right. There we go. So I am using, I think, Broken China Oxide on this, just because it was a little bit darker and I would get more of the effect on that one. So I just redid that one. And I was too lazy to use my heat tool, so I just rolled over the thing of kitchen roll there to dry it, and that seems to have worked. And now I'm going to go around the edges with, oh, I keep forgetting the colours. I should have written them down. I usually do. And because my video isn't saved in HD yet, I can't actually see what it says on that lid. But the correct colors will all be in the description box. I think it's Stormy Skies, I think, and then I'm going to use Faded Jeans on the darker ones, maybe. I think I'm right there. But yes, just going around the edges just to add, you know, that more depth and interest and stuff. And then once that is all done, oh, I'm still going there, the Stormy Sky looks really good on that paper, I think. Again, gives it that really nice sort of icy, cold, snowy effect. But yes, once those are done, I'm then going to go around the edges of every single piece with this lovely little silver ink. Just gives it that lovely little silver metallic glow or hint around the edges, which I really, really like. So yes, I think that is what I'm going to do to all of these pieces now. And then I'm going to obviously put them together. So just adding some glue on three sides of the pocket and then just sticking it on. I decided to go with wet glue just in case I put it down wrong. If you use double-sided tape, you don't have a chance to redo it, so just to adjust it if I needed to. And then just to add something interesting on the front of the pockets, I do actually go back later and add more interesting things, but just this was my starting off point. I'm just using some of that, what, diamante trim? Is that what we'll call it? That's what we'll call it. Using some of that from the kit, but putting it straight on there didn't look quite right, so I've just torn up some vellum just to have behind it. Just makes it look a bit lighter, a bit softer, and just using hot glue gum, not something I often use actually, to put those down. And then I actually regretted this. I also used the hot glue gun at first to stick these into my album, and they just came off immediately. Here I am doing it now. They just immediately popped off as soon as the glue set, so I did just go back and do it with gloss gel medium. I just should have just done that in the first place. I was trying to be lazy because the glue gun was already there and ready and hot. And anyways, lesson learned. So the next bit I'm going to do is this kind of front page for my album, which is this December cut file that I created myself on my Silhouette software. And I've cut it on some blue glitter card, and I'm just going to take the silver paint, acrylic paint from the kit, and just paint the back of it silver, like so. I'm going to do two layers of that, I think, just to make it, you know, a really nice strong silver color. If anyone would like this cut file, any Silhouette users out there, I'm more than happy to share it. It's totally mine because I created it from scratch, so yeah, just drop me an email if you'd like it. I'm not saying like everyone's gonna want it or anything, but you know, I might as well share it because I have it. If anyone does want to use it, then email me and I'll send you a copy of the cut file. So I am just drying between layers here, and what I'm doing here is the paper had started to warp a bit with all that paint, and I'm using my heat tool on purpose to warp it back into shape. Now sometimes with heat tools, the way they warp paper can be a bit of a pain, but sometimes you can actually use it to your advantage to warp it back into place, which is what I was doing here, and it worked quite well actually. And then I'm adding my second layer of paint there, and I kind of kept moving it around because depending on which way the light was hitting it, you could see where, you know, there was different patchy bits and stuff. Now the way I have painted this in a kind of a sloppy way has meant the silver paint has come through onto the front of it, which I kind of did on purpose because it kind of adds that distressed effect around it, and I was just kind of enhancing that with a couple of little extra dabs. Obviously if you didn't want that, then you would have to be a little bit more careful when painting the back. So now I'm just showing you, I'm taking some papers and I have cut them into more manageable bits. I haven't cut them all like little bits and stuff and all those little 2x2s and stuff because they're more likely to get lost that way over the course of the month. But just, yeah, as I said, cut them into more manageable pieces. All of those papers were from the kit, by the way. And now I'm going to take a piece of acetate and do some stenciling on it. I think stenciling on acetate often looks very, very lovely. It takes a while to dry, so you've got to leave it overnight. But yeah, I've mixed up some Nouveau Embellishment Mousse in blue something. Why can't things just have normal cut colour names like light blue and green and bright red? But no, they've got to have fancy names. Anyway, something blue, some modelling paste and some coarse white glitter, and using the snowflake stencil from the kit to put that over my acetate, like so. Now, don't freak out when I start to use my heat tool on this. I just wanted to use it to like dry the edges of where I'd done some stenciling so I can put my stencil back down without smooshing what I've already done. But it is actually heat proof acetate, so do not worry, it is designed for doing like stamping and embossing on, so you can use a heat tool on it. Although I feel very comfortable doing it. Like, I know it's supposed to be fine, but it's still plastic, you know, it kind of freaks me out. Anyway, with that done, I am taking some watercolor paper. This is a very bitty video, by the way, in case you hadn't noticed. I'm going back and forth doing all sorts of things except any actual scrapbooking, just preparation. Anyway, I'm taking some watercolor paper, cutting it down to size, and then using my marker to punch the holes in it. That watercolor paper, by the way, was very cheap. It was from the works. It's not the greatest quality, but it is white, which is something that's hard to find with watercolor paper. It's usually often that off-white or cream color, and I want white, damn it. Anyway, on these, I'm just going to do some packaging technique with distress oxides and some other mediums. I'm going to use candied apple and lucky clover for this. Oh, this is where I confess, by the way, I'm not going with the blue and silver theme throughout my whole album. Yes, I know it's shocking, but this is my first time doing a December album, and I kind of just want to do all of the Christmassy things. So yeah, I'm not making it all match. I'm going for traditional colors, modern colors, and doing all the things basically. But anyway, yes, packaging technique on those. And by the way, just in case anyone says, I do know the latest release of distress oxides had some more appropriate Christmas reds and greens, but the timing was just not good releasing before Christmas. I'm not getting any new colors till the new year. So anyways, I stuck with the colors I already had, and I think they work fine. On that page, by the way, I used a mix of Heidi Swap Colour Shine in Ocean and then splattered on some Heidi Swap in Navy as well. This one I'm going to go back to the Tumbled Glass because it's just such a beautiful colour. I love it so much. And yeah, more packaging, packaging technique. Here, Heidi's Bob Colour Shine in gold, which I rarely use for anything but splatters. So this was a fun little change for once. So yeah, I've just packaging technique again with that. With the Heidi Swap Colour Shine, I find it easier to spray onto the paper and then smush the packaging over the top, whereas with other mediums, it's easier to do it on the packaging and then put it on, if that makes any sense. I don't know why, it just seems to work better that way. Splattering over that green just then was, again, Heidi Swap in cherry. And here I'm just spraying some silver ink. This is kind of a homemade spray. It's a mix of a Caldo drawing ink, which I got from the works, but you cannot get anymore, it seems. It's sort of a 40-60 ratio of ink to water there for the silver, because it's really, really thick and gloopy kind of ink. And then, yeah, those are done. Put those aside to dry. I'm getting lost here. I'm going to cut up some bits of paper here just to the right size to fit in my album. I've got stuff from the kit, stuff from my stash and vellum. These papers here, the blue ones, are from Helt's Couple Ditch Wonderland from last year. Still love that collection. And the colours are really good to match my album. Not that, as I said, I am doing different colours in the album, but still. Some of the pages I'm just having single-sided, some of them double-sided. I'm just very much kind of going with the flow, doing what I feel like. And I'm not doing loads and loads of prep. I know this video is like 17 minutes long, but I still, relatively speaking, haven't done tons and tons of prep. I think when it comes to December, I think I don't want too much done in advance, because I think for me personally, that's going to block my creative flow just a tad. So just having these really simple things done in preparation is just way, way better for me. So, you know, better mixed media packaging technique or whatever on some white, couple of blank papers to do something on, you know, that kind of thing. I've just got the basics ready for myself rather than anything particularly complex, as it were. Now I think we are drawing slightly near to the end, finally. Oh wait, no, I've just remembered something else I did. No, totally ignore me. Those bits there, actually, those are leftovers from the Daphne's Diary diary from this past year, which I stopped using in about June. But I did go through it and pick out all the really pretty things in there. And there were these two wintry things. And the December one has on one side like a December calendar, which I thought would be really handy. And the other side has this wish list. And I thought, well, that would be great for like towards the beginning of my album. So I'm just decorating that page a little bit here with some of that thin washi that's from the kit. And then the other washies I'm going to use are just Christmas washies from my stash. I have one or two. And I'm doing the blue theme on the front, the December page, and the red theme on the back. Just, you know, make it a little bit different. And I did make a mistake and punch it on the wrong side slightly later on. I punched it so that the wish list would be on the front, and I didn't want that one, the December, to be on the front. But anyway, I think I go back to that in a bit. Now I'm just decorating my pockets a little bit more, because I just kind of wasn't happy with them. They just needed to be a little bit more exciting. So I'm just adding various little bits from the kit, some tags and stickers and stuff, just to look pretty. And I'm gonna add a load of these Tim Holtz Christmas clipping stickers, because I am mildly in love with them. You got one sheet in the kit, and as you may have noticed, I bought the whole pack. I just love them, they're fabulous. Anyways, all of those I'm adding silver ink around the edges too, and then just sticking them on there, just various appropriate little sayings there. So yes, oh, Nuvo drops, of course, those are in the color Neptune turquoise. I did forget that I'd put them on and shut the album. Yeah, I did, and I got Nuvo drops on that December page. But actually, when I looked at it, I was like, actually, that kind of matches, so I'm gonna put more Nuvo drops on there, just covering up my mistakes, putting some more Tim Holtz things on the wishlist page there, and then figuring out that I'd punched it on the wrong side and covering that up with washi so I can punch it on the right side. Acetate is now dry. I believe this is the next day, and I am punching that again with my marker and having that acetate behind that December page, because I thought that would look really, really pretty behind that blue glitter December, some white snowflakes peeking through there. Yeah, I thought that would work. And next, I believe I'm going to take those little papers, those sort of long thin ones, here they are, which are the original album from the kit, which I made a little bit bigger for my own personal album. And I'm just, again, I'm just prepping these with some distress oxides. I'm just swooshing the colours over there. And I thought I would use these for, well, various things. Like, I thought I could use them for journaling. If I'd done a page that I didn't want to put journaling straight on the page, then I could have like this little extra bit to put journaling on. Or for days in December, you know, when there's not that much going on, I can just use one of these little things, just, you know, have a tiny little thumbnail picture kind of thing. So yeah, I'm using, again, candied apple, lucky clover, tumble glass, and a little bit of ice spruce as well. Oh, and old paper there, just for a slightly different one. I really like that one on the left there that I did with the tumble glass, where I'd kind of pushed it on quite heavy and started at an angle, and it like looks like a kind of an arrow kind of thing. So yeah, I was quite happy with that one. I think I'm gonna do it again with one of the other colors. Yep, there I go. I think it looks kind of cool. Anyways, with those done, I've just paper clicked those together so they're ready to go, just putting them in the back there. And then I looked at the back and went, oh, I need to make this one pretty as well. So again, using just another couple of little bits from the kit. This was fussy cut from one of those papers, the sort of hexagony paper, obviously you can tell that. And I'm not sure if that little phrase was from the ephemera or from one of the cutter parts, but either way, it's Case of Craft Winter Wonderland, in case you're wondering. And again, round the edges with the silver ink, and just start those down with double-sided tape. I might do more to it, I haven't decided yet, but for now, a certain amount of it is done and I'm pretty happy with it. And now I'm just gonna go through all my little prep pages that I've created, make sure I'm happy with them. Again, I'm not doing loads. Finishing off, putting some stuff in my pocket, and for now, that is it. So, whew, slightly longer video than usual for me to do a voiceover. I hope you enjoyed it anyway. I don't know if I'll be doing any more prep work or not. If I do, obviously I will film it for you. I am hoping to do, however, another prep video showing you how I store all my Christmas supplies, so look out for that, hopefully next week, but I haven't filmed it yet, so we'll all find out. Other than that, thank you always so much for watching. Please leave me a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Links to the kit and all other items used will be in the description box below. Chat to me in the comments. Subscribe if you haven't. You know all the usual YouTube things that YouTubers say at the end of their videos. It's about time for me to go. Thank you so much again. I'm going. Bye!